10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
In May of 2013, Cardonald College's School of Supported Learning held its inaugural Health and Wellbeing Week, carefully crafted by our own Little Miss Healthy. Or should that be Little Miss Tiny?
First aid courses.
This is actually quite easy to do.
I'm going to give you these sheets out and you are going to have a game.
Well, alcohol takes about half an hour to reach your brain.
The idea behind the events was to encourage our students to actively take part in a variety of health-related activities, some of which they may not have experienced before. We also wanted to help them gain confidence by making choices to promote a healthier, happier lifestyle. The students learned all about how their bodies work, with lots of interactive fun activities, including can you put the organs back into the body and how fast does your heart beat? We're really grateful to our new friends at the Glasgow Science Centre who brought Body Vision on tour to Cardonald College, although students have been told to only let a doctor remove any body parts. Don't try this at home.
You know that you're meant to stop and run in the spot for 30 seconds? And then do it in a minute and see what happens.
Have you ever heard of pecs before? Ever heard guys talking about their pecs?
Yeah.
Do you know where they are?
Somewhere.
Sort of these muscles. Okay. Now this one, that muscle is called the trapezius. Well, this is the muscle that, nod your head like that.
Right.
That's the one that pulls our head back. So where do you think it might go?
Somewhere in the back?
Yeah, exactly.
As Margaret Campbell from the Learning for Independence course tries on a set of beer goggles to find out what it feels like to be drunk, the students of the healthcare department carried out activities on the theme of nutrition. Senior lecturer Pat Gourley and her team discussed the importance of drinking water and eating fruit, the effect of alcohol on the body, and the dangers of the sun. Well, when Scotland actually gets any.
Your liver when you drink too much.
There's a picture down there of a healthy liver compared to
somebody that drinks too much alcohol. And obviously the other side effects of drinking alcohol is if you drink, like I said to you how much you drink and he says you don't know. That's normally good that you don't know how much you've drank. That means you've drank too much. And obviously there's also like the safety side of it, like anything could happen, you could hurt yourself, you could fall, you could bang your head. You could end up getting out of trouble off the police. Do you know how much it is to get, a on-the-spot fine for breach of the peace? Do you know how much it is? £40. And if you don't pay that within 28 days, it goes up to £60. And that's just through drinking, but not just that, drinking costs the government £20 billion every year.
Vodka's
not good. Vodka's an evil drink. It is. It just brings out the worst in people.
You're allowed to have sweets sometimes, like food and drinks, high fat, or sugar, but not a lot of it. That's what means by balanced diet. So, does it mean you can eat healthy constantly, you can have a treat now and again, but no binge.
And this is another disease that can happen through the sun.
Skin cancer?
It's too much sun. It can harm your skin, especially see with the likes of sunbeds and stuff like that. It's really, really not good for your skin. It needs But see if you ever, this is just examples to see like, just for in future if you ever notice stuff like this, you know, like it's always good to know about it. So the best thing is to look up about it, read on. When you get sunstroke, you end up feeling sick, you don't feel right, you just, you get hot, you get cold constantly. It's really not a good thing to have. It's a small price to pay just for putting on sun lotion, you know, and it can help. It's that big difference. And see, like eating the likes of fruit and stuff like that, and energising your skin, making it a lot more vibrant, and so it isn't going to get burnt as easy.
It will say, like, if like, parents or people get kids and they're drinking in front of the kids, it could harm the kids, and it's not really fair on the kids. No. Because it could give them like asthma or heart disease.
Next, it was pamper time, as the students of the School of Hair and Beauty teamed up with their head of school, Doris Graham, to provide facials, makeup demonstrations, and the chance to do each other's nails.
So, Trisha, how do you feel about two young men painting your nails?
It's very relaxing, and they're doing very well. At least they're staying inside the nail area.
Let's have a look and see how Pervinda's doing.
Pervinda's doing very well. He's a bit out of the nail at the start, but now he's actually going really well inside.
Right, guys, here's some more exciting colours coming. Make sure that we talk to screwed on quite tight if you're finished.
I have to admit, this is the most embarrassing thing I've ever done.
Let me see.
This one then?
Let me see.
This is the one without the glitter. Aidan at the moment is just dressing
them
up just now.
So, Aidan, what do you think about a new career as a nail technician?
Well, I have to get used to it one day. So,
isn't that wonderful? The glitter is so beautiful. The thumb one.
Don't to keep up.
He's read you from spectacular nails to finger painting.
You look as if you've cut yourself, Trisha.
Pervinda went over.
So, Pervinda, a change of career, I think, awaits. No comment.
I'm not at this.
I wonder who enjoyed it the most, the girls or the boys? Scotland has identified alcohol abuse as one of the biggest threats to individual and family health. The latest research shows that twice as many Scots die from alcohol-related causes than anywhere else in the UK. The Glasgow Council on Alcohol Awareness team came in to teach the students about the effects of drinking, how to understand the concept of units of alcohol, and ways of keeping safe when enjoying a drink.
Drinking spirits warms you up if you're really cold. Do you think that's true or false? Okay, and are you guys myth or in the middle? What happens when you drink alcohol is the heat rises up to the surface of your skin, which is why you might feel warm and some people get rosy cheeks when they've been drinking. But all the heat's going away from their core. So eventually when the heat rises up to your skin, it will eventually leave your body. So it actually is cooling you down, even though while you're drinking you might feel warm. Why is this a really bad thing if people are drinking outside in Scotland in December? You could get hypothermia or pneumonia. Yeah, if someone gets so drunk that they sat down and fell asleep outside, well, they could
die.
Get really, really ill. They could possibly die.
Black coffee can sober you up.
A total myth.
These are absolutely 100% correct. The only thing that does sober you up is time. So all these other things like iron brew or having a fry up and a pint of water or going for a cold shower, they might make you feel better if you're hungover. But if you've got alcohol in your body from the night before drinking and you have a black coffee or an iron brew, the alcohol hasn't went anywhere, it's still in your body, so it's not sobered you up at all.
And from alcohol to tobacco. Glasgow Community Health Partnership's Smoking Cessation Unit did everything they could to persuade us all what a nasty habit smoking is by showing us what actually clogs up our lungs if we smoke. Ugh.
So,
benzene, and that's in petrol fumes. You know when you go to the petrol station to put petrol in the car, that's in tobacco.
Do you think the same chemical that's in paint stripper is in tobacco smoke, so true or false? Ammonia, which is very strong smelling and it's found in cleaning products, do you think that's found in tobacco smoke? Butane, which is found in lighter fuel, so that's what people light lighters with. So you think that's in nicotine? Smoke? Which is a very addictive drug. Do you think that's found in cigarettes? If you So actually the answer is that every single one of these things are found in tobacco smoke. So every single one of them are true.
If you ever tried a cigarette, you could have got bone cancer. It could actually smoke, because somebody in my family smoked and it really gets to me.
Has anybody ever just tried one cigarette?
Here's Veronica McElroy, head of School of Health and Life Sciences, showing us how to take care of our teeth by regular brushing, and what could happen to our gnashers if we don't look after them.
How many sets of teeth do you get in your life?
A wisdom tooth.
You get a wisdom tooth when you're an adult.
Mm-hmm. And you get bracelets.
And you get braces. You're really right, yes. That's a good guess. Why do you get braces?
Every your teeth is very, very bad.
And your heart's, where's your heart? Show me where your heart is.
Yeah.
That's there. That's quite near your mouth, isn't it?
Oh.
So you can get nasty bacteria getting into your heart as well, giving you heart problems. Did you know that?
Aye, because there was an advert on the telly saying that pyorrhea could lead to heart disease.
Pyorrhea, well done. How do you know that big word?
Because I hear it all the time.
You hear it from?
The telly.
On the telly.
Aye, because there was a sign the telly saying that in the old days they used to catch pyorrhea all the time. It's the way their teeth fall out.
My daddy smoke.
Oh, does he? Is his teeth all yellow?
Yeah.
Well, he has to get them clean, doesn't he?
I told him smoking not good for your diabetes.
No, it's not.
It's not good for your lungs.
No, it's not good for your lungs either.
It's made me ill and make it smell bad.
Makes you smell bad, does it? It's not nice, is it?
It's bad.
But what happens is, you smoke it, your lovely white teeth go discoloured and they go brown, don't they?
But if you eat lots of nasty sugar, what happens is the sugar builds up and it goes under your gum, and you were saying bleeding gums. What happens is then, your gum gets really, really annoyed and angry at all the bacteria going underneath there. And that's not a healthy gum. See when it goes that red, sore way, and gets nice and swollen, well, not nice and swollen, bad and swollen, and you touch them and you get a drip of blood. You shouldn't have that.
And then what you do is you can have your sugar-free chewing gum, and that cleans all your mouth, doesn't it? And it cleans all your teeth. But what do you do with the chewing gum when you're
you spit it out?
Where are you spit it?
You find them in the bin.
Actually, sometimes I'm not in a spit, and if I can't get to a bin, just kind of put it down the toilet.
Andrew and the sports department HND students took us through a fitness testing programme, which rounded off with gym inductions to enable the students to use the college gym facilities. The supported learning students also took part in team building games like basketball and badminton, plus some funky dance routines with Lauren and Jill. Gangnam style, anyone?
Set the weight that you want. If you feel uncomfortable doing proper dips and chins, I'd suggest a slightly heavier weight, not the full stack, because you won't be able to control it, probably somewhere in the middle. Right, so you adjust the speed of the treadmill. It's just the grey buttons here, okay? So you can bring it up. You see, it's going faster now, so my legs are having to work harder. If you want, bring it straight up to a jog.
This time you're gonna change your blood pressure.
in your hard drive. Okay? You've done this before? Bye. So one here, please. I'll show you.
If I pop me, I'm going to scream.
Right, put your hand here. Relax.
Push with that. Just do that and take your arm away. Don't push right in. Just punch it and take your arm away.
Oh, I think we need some calm after all that exertion in the gym. Well, the students of Choose Health 2 ran sessions on relaxation techniques like hand and arm massages, facials, back, neck and shoulder rubs, and fully clothed seated massages, all within the soothing confines of the Chillaxation Clinic.
Heard about the hazards in health and safety, haven't you?
Yeah,
okay. Right, so I'm going to give you these sheets out and you are going to have a game where you're going to spot the hazard.
Sometimes I get a good feeling. Yeah. Get a feeling that I never had before.
I'm Trisha and the class today is Spot the Hazard. The main purpose of Spot the Hazard is health and safety. It's all about health and safety. And this is just a bit of fun where the students can actually recognise the hazards. And within the hazards, there's hazards in the home that can be an everyday hazard that you probably don't even take into consideration. So this piece of work is fun, but it also has a purpose behind it, which is education and health.
Have a look at it. Does the tree look as if it's a hazard?
What I want you to do is, I want you to take that away with you, and then when you go home tonight, have a wee look about your house, have a wee look about your room, and see if you can spot any hazard that's in the house. And if you do spot them, see what you can do to fix it.
Next, first aid skills, showing the students what to do when an accident happens, how they can help others if they're choking, and how to apply bandages. So don't forget to look out for the mummies. Only joking.
Okay, so I've done it round that way. So that one is pointing to the broken arm. So put that up there, over your shoulder. Right? And then place this bit underneath and then tuck it in that wee bit there. That's you. And then just turn that and fix it. And make sure everything's alright. Oh, I didn't tie that well, that's my fault. I'm not a good tire either, I can't tie. That's you. And that's the sling. Alright, how's that feel?
Cheek. That's right. And then if you come to this side, just stand next to me. Then see if you just tilt her furthest away, if you tilt her knee up. And then if you gently just grab her shoulder and her knee, just roll her over. And then the last thing you would do is just check her away and tilt her head back, just so.
If you come across somebody that is choking, what would you do?
Now,
first of all, you've got to ask your casualty, are you choking? You'll come across someone, their face will be red, they'll be really distressed, they'll be grabbing their throats. They maybe can't say, I'm choking. They can't speak. So you have to say to them, are you choking? And they'll nod. What we do is we encourage them to cough. We say, try and cough. They may be able to cough this up, but perhaps they can't. You turn around. Now, Dominique is choking. She's trying to cough, it won't come up. So what I'm going to say to her is bend a little bit, just a little bit. I'm going to use my hand here, and I'm going to give her blows to the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of these blows. Now we're hoping that these blows will dislodge whatever it is that's stuck in her throat. So after we've done that, we'll check, is that successful? And perhaps it's not. If it is successful, we reassure her because she'll have had an awful fright. Have any of you ever choked?
Yes.
Isn't it? You have. Isn't it a horrible?
I've actually choked 3 times.
Oh.
Aye.
Well, just as well all your class know what to do now. But say it's not successful. What we're going to do is we're going to give 5 abdominal thrusts. So we turn Dominique round, put her arms up, and I'm going to put my hands here, make a fist, and I'm going to pull up like that 5 times. And see if that is successful. If it is, great, we'll sit her down, reassure her, because she's in a terrible fright. But if it's not successful, we have to go back to the back blows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Check, is it cleared? If not, we have to go back to the abdominal thrusts. And what we're trying to do in the abdominal thrusts is move this thing that is stuck. The biggest fright I ever had was when a little child choked on a grape. Can you imagine a grape? They didn't chew it and they just swallowed it and that grape was stuck. And that's what I was trying to dislodge. So, we do this 3 times. And if it doesn't help, if it doesn't work, then we dial 999.
Our lifelong learning students promoted health by demonstrating their interactive 3D storyboards and distributing leaflets with a selection of healthy Go Rehydrate juices on tap to sample.
We're using this as part of the health and wellbeing week. Looking at what a really good for you.
Welcome.
So also the tea, we had some water and we had mango juice, but it's all gone. So it's went away. This is just what we're left with.
Give me just a flavour of this whole activity, what it was all about.
Well, it's all about promoting health and wellbeing. All right, we want the students to come in and interact with the posters that the students have made in lifelong learners. And to just take some leaflets away with them so that they can have time to reflect on their diet and their health and their wellbeing.
And drink.
And they have a wee drink in the process.
What was your thoughts on the water, Agnes?
Oh, Brian, it was absolutely delicious and I could absolutely drink it all the time.
Because see, the more you touch your spots in your face, right, you're spreading the germs about. So ideally what you want to do is not touch your face and just wash your hands. Yeah, because you're touching things, everybody's touching things, door handles, lifting things up, that's transferring a lot of germs.
Next, Margaret Grant taught the students all about their senses of smell and touch. It's amazing how your senses can trick you when you're wearing a blindfold.
Taking off you, Christopher, and I'm going to see the arm.
I can see the bottom.
Does anyone know what that is? This task is, when us send these smells round, now you might find you can smell the plastic. What you have to think about is, see this one, the orange one?
Yeah.
What's in that? Is it orange? Is it grapefruit? Right? Okay.
I think it's mint.
So that is the lavender one.
Like,
did you recognise
well, this one here?
Yeah,
you can recognise the lavender. The yellow one as well. Wouldn't have thought it was lavender.
Once again, Pat Gourley's team from healthcare treated the students to health screening, which involved more blood pressure testing, but they also found out how strong their lungs are using a peak flow meter.
That's really good. The higher it is, the better it is. Try again.
Do you want me to
tighten
the
air?
Spot on. It's fine.
Whoa. That's really good. Should we try one more time?
How powerful lungs.
That's actually really good considering you're asthmatic. Do you smoke?
No!
I do not.
That's actually really good though.
530. You have to do it 3 times though. 3 times. Okay. Samsung. Samsung. Well, snuff at that round your hand, your arm. Keep pressing the button. And what you'll feel is it going all tingly and tight in your arm. Don't worry, this is how we measure how well your heart and all your blood
Healthier than you? Are you a medical student?
Yeah. My blood pressure's quite high. Don't know why though.
Your blood pressure isn't?
I think it's just naturally quite high.
The Health Week also hosted healthy food tasting sessions with lecturer Anne Shearer and her lifelong learning class. While Nancy Littlejohn ran a practical Green Fingers gardening session, all about encouraging us to grow our own vegetables.
Lifelong learning Green Fingers gardening class. And what everyone's going to do is they're going to choose from 3 vegetables to grow. They're going to throw solar seeds, put them in little pots, and put them in their little designer bags, take them away and grow on at home and then enjoy the fruits of their labours. That's the idea. Green Fingers. Once you've sown your seeds, once you've sown your seeds and you've watered them, you go back to the compost.
All your planting shopping comes in a stylish paper-thin bag. Plus a brochure. Get in all gardening stores. Like Homebase. Or B&Q. Oh, that's the spirit. The gardening gets even fun with the summer coming up. Yes.
Okay. It tells us how to take care of your plant when you go home. And it has a recipe on the back for delicious, yummy lettuce soup.
Sandra Wright then tested all of our brains with some very tricky questions. At the end of the event, we invited the students to have a seat on the Big Brother chair and reflect on their experiences of the Health Week activities. Unfortunately, Davina McCall was busy, so student Andros Withers from Moving On to Work handled her duties with the equivalent amount of enthusiasm and polished professionalism.
Big Brother Reflections today in Cardonald College. Moving on to work, our supportive learning classes. We all get a chance to know what health's about. Food, drink, and other things. Exercise your brain. Green Fingers. The health screening. To know if the health's up to date. And not to eat fatty foods, of course. They all done well, didn't they?
My favourite activity was the promoting health, because I got 4 bottles of coconut water.
What my best activity was is the first aid. I liked it because it was I learned how to put people in the recovery position.
The best activity I thought was going down to the gym.
Well, I learned I'm pretty healthy. Apart from my tummy, I've got good heart rate, I've got a good pulse.
I enjoyed the gym sessions and basketball because it was very active. I like that sort of stuff.
Right. So the best activity is health screen because I like it. One you learn. Senses, because you smell different things, you know that. I like to see healthcare next year, but I like to see something different.
Term on session.
Okay. And you liked it, why? Because it relaxed you?
Yeah. My best activity was promoting health. Has it helped you learn new food and all that kind of stuff?
Okay. The thing that I enjoyed most in Health Week was a chillaxation, mainly because you got to have a, it was chillaxing basically. It was like you get to do facials and stuff, and that was kind of my favourite part.
The one thing that I learned about health is my proper blood pressure, what it should be, and also how to keep healthy.
also into this room, and lo and behold, health group organiser Sharon Scott is tidying it all away. It's all done, Sharon. How do you feel?
Shattered.
It seems like a long time now since Tuesday, doesn't it?
It does, but it's been a quiet week and I think everybody's had a lot of fun.
What's been your highlights?
Highlights, my goodness. Well, one of my groups ran the chillaxation clinic, which was really good for them. We saw Body Vision at the Science Centre, that was really good fun, when they came in. And today we've managed to see some dance classes and some health classes. There's been a bit of first aid going on, so people are walking about going, I know how to do a bandage now. So lots of different things. Healthy eating tasting sessions, we've had them, that's been really good. And
Big Brother.
Big Brother, yes, Big Brother seemed to go down well. We've just actually finished, that's what I'm actually sorting out just now.
So that is now the remains that, of
this
the
is the remains
chair.
Of the Big Brother chair, yes.
Which means it's all over for another year.
Yes.
Did any students in particular surprise you with how interested they were in, you know, did they really kind of excel themselves?
A lot of the students actually did, engaged really, really well in things. Some students I thought, you know, didn't seem that interested to begin with. Once they actually get into the swing of it, they just blossomed. So that was really good.
The pub tonight, is it?
No, we're promoting health and wellbeing, thank you. That's only for a weekend activity.
Fruit juice, obviously.
Yes, or coconut water.
Indeed. And until next year.
Adios. See you later.
So, Chip, can you tell me what your best activity of the health week was? Right. Oh, really? And why was that? Yeah, excellent.
Thank you and goodbye.
To see the students and staff smiling, being actively engaged and having fun, participating in all of the health and wellbeing events was such a pleasure to see. We hope that the health and wellbeing events will be an annual fixture and something we can all look forward to in promoting our own health and wellbeing. We would like to say a big thanks to everyone who took part and for making the event the resounding success it became. Students, staff, external contributors, we couldn't have done it without you. Thank you.